Hey squad, now I have a very exciting episode because we are talking about how to get rid of stubborn belly fat. Now, we've already talked about the fact that you cannot spot reduce fat or target fat loss. However, I think it's important to mention not all fat is the same. In fact, there are 6 different types of fat that reside in our body. 6. I think I need my coffee before we get started. So, what are the 6 types of fat that have taken up residency in our bodies? Number 1, essential fat. This is the fat that can be found in the brain, nerves, bone marrow, and visceral membranes that protect our organs. Now, we get this type of fat from the healthy fats we eat, such as salmon, mackerel, nuts, seeds, avocados, you name it. Number 2, white fat. Now, white fat is probably the most abundant fat we have in our system, and it is the fat that accumulates very easily and very quickly when we overeat in calories. That being said, white fat does serve a purpose. It is essential for energy storage and hormone regulation, in particular for the secretion of a hormone called leptin. Now, leptin is responsible for signaling to our brain that we are full up and we have enough fat stored away to be used at a later date. However, we can become resistant to leptin. And when we become resistant to leptin, our brains ignore those signals and it can cause us to have cravings that are uncontrollable, especially high fat, high sugar, junk food based cravings. Moving on to number 3, brown fat. Now, this is said to be the good fat because it activates when we are cold. It burns calories to heat us up and regulate our temperature. Now, that being said, babies have more brown fat than adults, and this is because of their inability to shiver. We also typically store the very little brown fat we have around our shoulders and neck. Moving on to number 4, beige fat. Now, this is said to have characteristics of both white fat and brown fat, but it functions mostly like brown fat in which it burns calories to produce heat when our core body temperature drops. Moving on to number 5, subcutaneous fat. The fat that is jiggly, pinchable, and located all over the body, just under the skin. Now, it's made up of white, brown, and beige fat, but predominantly white fat. It too has a function and a purpose. It acts as padding for our muscles and bones, as well as a passageway for our nerves and blood vessels between the skin and the muscles. Lastly, we are gonna hit number 6, visceral fat. The stubborn fat that lives rent-free in our abdominal cavity, surrounding our organs, and won't vacate easily. In fact, it's the fat that is so stubborn it wants to put up a fight. But I'm gonna share with you 5 tips that you can start implementing that will help knock it back down to size. Now, don't get me wrong, in small quantities, visceral fat helps to protect the organs. But when it grows too large, it is very harmful and it's something we need to get rid of. So before I share those 5 tips, let's do today's journal entry. Today's journal entry prompt is a powerful one. It is, the most alive I felt recently is when. Now, you don't have to share this one in the comment section, especially if it's personal, but it's a great way to end the week. When was the last time you felt the most alive? Really think about it. Anyway, back to getting rid of this stubborn belly fat. Tip number 1 to getting rid of stubborn belly fat, eat more soluble fiber. Now, soluble fiber forms a thick gel-like substance that slows down the absorption of macronutrients, in particular sugars, and this helps to stabilize our blood sugar levels. It also helps lower LDL cholesterol and makes us feel fuller for longer. But here's the best part, it has prebiotic properties that helps to feed the gut and helps the gut produce short-chain fatty acids. Now, these short-chain fatty acids are known to metabolize fat, meaning it increases fat burn and decreases fat storage. So, eat more soluble fiber. On to tip number 2, protein. Increase your protein intake. Now, I've talked about protein in several episodes, and I'm talking about it again today because it does several things. It boosts your metabolism, it helps regulate your water balance, it builds and repairs your tissues. In addition, it helps oxygenate your red blood cells. Now, the more oxygen that we can carry, the more fat that we can get rid of. Protein is essential in your fat loss journey as well as your muscle growth journey. On to point number 3, reduce your stress. It's important that you bring your stress levels down, as stress has been linked to an increase in cortisol release, and high cortisol levels has been linked directly to high levels of visceral fat. Now, reducing your stress can be done by meditating, doing yoga, but more importantly, getting yourself to sleep. Sleep is important. It helps to actually metabolize and break down all of that excess cortisol, which is a surefire way to help you reduce your visceral fat. Sleep has other benefits as well. It helps us repair, it helps us grow our muscle tissue. It does so many wonderful things. So please, bring that stress level down, go to sleep, and try some meditation. On to point number four, sugar. Dramatically reduce your sugar intake. You've heard this before, but why should you do it? Well, that's because sugar is made up of glucose and fructose. And whilst every cell in our body can utilize glucose, only the liver can metabolize fructose. Now, fructose is found in almost all of our favorite snacks and junk foods. It's found in sodas, fruit juices, honey, syrups. And so it makes its way into our diet very easily. The problem is when the liver becomes overloaded, it turns all of that fructose into fat and the liver gets overloaded quite quickly. So please reduce your sugar and watch your waistline reduce. On to point number five, exercise. In particular, high intensity exercise. Now, it's important to note all exercise is gonna help us burn fat, but the reason I bring up high intensity exercise is we burn more calories in a shorter space of time. It helps us to build muscle. The more muscle we have, the higher our metabolism, and it helps to increase EPOC. EPOC stands for excess post-exercise oxygen consumption, which basically means we use more oxygen in the day. That being said, the more oxygen we use, the more fat we can burn. So those are your five tips to helping you fight stubborn belly fat. I hope you've enjoyed today's episode. I will be back again with another episode tomorrow. Make sure you give this video a big thumbs up, subscribe if you're not yet subscribed, drop a comment and let me know what else you want me to talk about. And of course, share this video with anybody that needs to lose stubborn belly fat. See you again tomorrow. Peace.